Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. I am Reesha and this is For the Love of Classics. I have been meaning to do a self-isolation book haul for a while now. I have accumulated a number of books during this period of self-isolation or quarantine or social distancing or whatever we are calling staying at home these days. So it's now time for a good old book haul. So without further ado, let's just jump right in because there are a lot of books I have gathered. The first book which I got is from Kinokuniya Dubai and it is a present from my husband. It is Oliver Twist by Charles Dickens. Ever since the Dickens series was launched by Vintage Classics, I have been meaning to buy one of these, but I already have most of Charles Dickens' books on my shelf. The six books which are available in this book series are Great Expectations, Oliver Twist, The Christmas Carol, Hard Times, David Copperfield, and A Tale of Two Cities. So I already have most of these books. The only two which I did not have were A Christmas Carol and Oliver Twist. I was not a huge fan of Charles Dickens in the beginning, but over the years I have grown to really enjoy his books and his writing style. And I plan to read all of his books one day. So that is the reason why I decided to buy Oliver Twist. This book is 436 pages long, but the writing inside the book is not very small. So that is definitely a bonus. And I love the black ends of these papers. This book also comes with deckled edges with a different pattern inside and it's beautiful to look at. So as most of you guys already know, Charles Dickens is a Victorian English writer. He wrote books in a serialized manner and the serialization of Oliver Twist began in the year 1837. The story is about Oliver, who is an orphan living on the dangerous London streets with no one but himself to rely on. Fleeing from poverty and hardship, he falls in with a criminal street gang who will not let him go however hard he tries to escape. I'm really glad to have this in my collection. I read David Copperfield by Charles Dickens this January and I had a really wonderful time reading it. So I'm looking forward to reading Oliver Twist by him. Next book which I got from Kinokuniya is by Anthony Trollope and it is Framley, Parsonage by Anthony Trollope in the Penguin English Library edition. This is the fourth volume in the Barsetshire Chronicles series by Anthony Trollope. Anthony Trollope is another Victorian writer and this book was published in the year 1861. As compared to the rest of the Victorian authors, I feel like Anthony Trollope's writing is so easy to get into. It's way simpler and the story and the plots are more fun and interesting. I love the Penguin English Library editions and I'm so glad to have another one of these in my collection. The next one I might already have mentioned in my vlogs, and it is The Warden by Anthony Trollope. This is the first book in the Barsetshire Chronicles series by Anthony Trollope and this is a vintage edition. I have already read this book and I have given it a 4-star rating out of 5. So The Warden was published in the year 1855 and it is the shorter of all the books in the series. It was a simple book with an uncomplicated plot. The themes of duty and self-righteousness were beautifully discussed in this book and I really enjoyed it. I've heard that the rest of the books in the series are way better than the first one, so I'm really looking forward to Barchester Towers, which is the second book in the Barsetshire Chronicles series. So the next book which I got is not a classic, it is a piece of non-fiction and it is called The Butchering Art by Lindsay Fitzharris. This was published in the year 2017. I feel very comfortable reading fiction and I'm hesitant in picking up a non-fiction book. So I wanted to buy a book which would interest me. And since this book is about history, medicine and the Victorian era, I think it has a combination of all the three things I love. So this book is about Joseph Lister's quest to transform the grisly world of Victorian medicine. I'm a doctor myself and reading about medical history and how it has evolved over the years is something I'm interested in. And I'm also really excited to collect more non-fiction books by Penguin with their orange spines. So it says on the back that it is a compelling, thoroughly enjoyable book which delves into the perilous world of 19th century surgery, revealing how Joseph Lister struggled to determine the basis of infection and establish his pioneering antiseptic system in the face of furious opposition. The result is not for faint-hearted. A rousing tale told with brio, featuring a real-life hero worthy of the ages and jolts of Victorian horror to rival the most lurid moments of Wilkie Collins. A gripping tale of medical endeavor paints a vivid picture of the stench and horror of the London that Lister knew, gory and eye-popping. Lindsay Fitzharris is also on Instagram, and she has a blog where she posts about medical history stuff. So if you are interested, you can follow her there. And she's currently working on her second book, which is about the history of plastic surgery. So I'm really looking forward for her second book as well. This was another present from my husband. So I keep looking at the small penguin little black classics, and they have always intrigued me. And since I've been reading fiction solely, I think it's time for me to start reading a little broadly. So I got myself two of these penguin little black spines. The first one is by Thomas Hardy, and it is A Woman Much Missed. Thomas Hardy is another Victorian author. I love Thomas Hardy's writing. His books are so peaceful and soothing to read. So it says right here that in 1870, Thomas Hardy went to Cornwall, where he met and fell in love with Emma Gifford, his first wife. Emma's death on 27th November 1912 inspired some of the finest verse of Hardy's career. This collection includes these poems along with others relating to Hardy's courtship, marriage, and widowed life. So this is going to be interesting. And the second of these, which I also got from Kinokuniya, is by Emily Bronte, another Victorian writer and poet. And it is called The Night is Darkening Round Me. So Emily Bronte is famous for her book Wuthering Heights. She does get a bit overshadowed by her older sister Charlotte Bronte, who is famous for Jane Eyre. So I'm really excited to read some poetry by these Victorian authors. So these were all the books from Kinokuniya. The next book which I got is from Book Depository, and it is Marriage by Susan Ferrier. I have already started reading this book, and I am on page 103. This is a pre-Victorian classic. It is written by an author who was contemporary of Jane Austen. She is a Scottish writer. So Marriage was Susan Ferrier's first novel. Her second novel is called The Inheritance, and her third novel is called Destiny. Marriage was published in the year 1810, and it was an immediate success. Her book was recognized by Sir Walter Scott, another famous author of the time. Susan Ferrier was also aware of Jane Austen at the time, and the opening line of her second novel, Inheritance, is actually very similar to Jane Austen's famous book, Pride and Prejudice. The opening goes something like this: "It is a truth universally acknowledged that there is no passion so deeply rooted in human nature as that of pride." So this story is about two generations of women. The first generation is that of Lady Juliana. She is supposed to get married to this older man who is very rich and holds a title, but she falls in love with a young, handsome soldier who is penniless, and she elopes with him and is disinherited. She goes with him to his homeland, Scotland. She always thought that she would be way happier if she married for love, but living in Scotland is a total nightmare for her, and she very soon repents following her heart. I don't think her other books are in publication. Only Marriage is published by Virago Modern Classics, and I'm really excited to read books by people other than Jane Austen from the Georgian era. So the next books which I got are from a pre-loved bookshop in Dubai called House of Prose. And the first one is The Good Soldier by Ford Madox Ford. So Ford was an English writer, and this book was published in the year 1915. He's famous for The Good Soldier and Parade's End. It's a short book, just 240 pages long. And it is a story about John and his wife when they befriend Edward and Leonora. They appear to be a perfect couple. He is a distinguished soldier and she is beautiful and intelligent. However, what lies beneath the surface of their marriage is far more sinister, and their influence leads John into a tragic drama. So I thought the summary sounded really interesting. So the first line of the novel is, "This is the saddest story I have ever heard." So I'm already intrigued. The next book which I got from House of Prose is Absalom, Absalom by William Faulkner. Now, I absolutely had no idea about William Faulkner, but after buying this book, I did a little bit of research and found out that He is an American writer. He lived in Mississippi. His books deal with the themes of racism in Southern America after the Civil War. And he was awarded the Nobel Prize for Literature in the year 1949. I've heard that his writing is a little difficult and dense to get into. But since I've already got this book, I would like to read it. If you have read William Faulkner, can you tell me if his writing is more difficult than George Eliot's? Because if it's not, then I think I can deal with it. But if it's more dense than George Eliot's writing, then I'll have to give it a second thought. Let me show you the book summary at the back. As a poor white boy, Sutpen was turned away from a plantation owner's mansion by a Negro butler. He was determined to force his way into the upper Southern society. His relentless will ensures his ambitions are soon realized: land, marriage, children. But after the chaos of civil war, secrets from his own past threaten to destroy everything he has worked for. So I think reading this might give an idea about how things were after the Civil War. So the last book which I got from House of Prose is The Shape of Things to Come by H.G. Wells. Now, H.G. Wells was born in the year 1866 and he died in 1946. He is famous for his books The Time Machine and The War of the Worlds, which are some of the pioneering works of science fiction. He wrote The Shape of Things to Come in the year 1933. Let me read the summary on the back. It says that when Dr. Philip Raven, an intellectual working for the League of Nations, dies in the year 1930, he leaves behind a powerful legacy, an unpublished dream book. Inspired by visions he has experienced for many years, it appears to be a book written far into the future, a history of humanity from the date of his death up to 2105. The Shape of Things to Come provides this history of the future, an account that was in some ways remarkably present, predicting climate disaster and sweeping cultural changes, including a Second World War, the rise of chemical warfare, and political instabilities in the Middle East. So this book is further divided into 5 books. I think it's going to take me a while to get into this book, because now that I look at it, it does not seem like a very easy read. It is definitely something out of my comfort zone, and I would love to read it someday. So those were all the books. I think I need to stop buying books because I already have 38 unread books on my shelf. And at the beginning of the year, there were 40 unread books. I've read 11 of them, but then I have also bought so many others. So my unread shelf does not seem to be making any progress, even though I have been reading constantly. Let me know if you guys have read any of these books. Did you like them? Did you hate them? I would love to hear from you guys. Thank you everyone for the positive comments. Please keep them coming. And I'm going to see you all in my next video very, very soon.